Hello everybody and welcome. I have a box to unbox. I am also absolutely starving. So I'm not only looking forward to this box to see what's in it, but I'm also looking forward to eating something. So as always, I've pulled all of the personal information off from the person who sent it and opened it up, because opening up is very, very noisy. There is a little letter on the top, which is ridiculously cute and also very neat. Very neat handwriting. Charlotte, I hope you enjoy this little box full of treats from Greece. Your videos have helped me slow my mind down whenever the world feels a little too much for my anxious brain. You are so unbelievably funny and imaginative, a lovely human inside and out. And then there's the word warmest greetings written in Greek, but then English underneath. I didn't just read Greek. I wish you a wonderful 2018, all the love and success you deserve, and a life full of happiness. Thank you for all your hard work, all the tingles, and for sharing your light with us. Warmest wishes, Vicky. And on the other side, there's a few Greek words. So she's, so she's done an angel, a daisy, cup of tea, love, and my name. So angel, pronounced angelos. So obviously there's a Greek word written there, and then she's written how it's pronounced. So angel is angelos in Greek. Daisy, pronounced margarita. Hey, didn't know that. Tea is pronounced chai, like chai latte. Charlotte, pronounced Charlotte. Is that right? Charlotte. Knows how I'm putting on this accent. I could be butchering these. And love is pronounced agape. Agape? Agape. 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 We'll go with that. So, angelos, margarita, chai, Charlotte, and agape. That's my Greek lesson for the day. The writing is so neat. How neat is her writing? Far neater than mine. I send people like thank you cards and letters, and I just think, try my hardest. Really neat, Charlotte, but then it just doesn't end up being neat. If you hear a little clicking and clunking, I've got a heater down here. My central heating is too loud to put on because the boiler is just outside this room. So it's really noisy in here, so I usually turn the heating off in the house, and I just have a little heater, so you might hear it clicking away. So I've just had to rip this side off, because it was getting in my way. Thank you. done almost. Like an aged feel to it. Like it's vintage paper. The reason I've got my microphone so close is because it's been struggling a little bit to pick up when it's further away. So I've brought it right into the shot so I can really pick up the quiet sounds just until I get my new microphones. This bubble wrap has a really dense, heavy, like a deep quality to the crinkle. Now this is a different one. Much lighter. Can you hear the difference? Two very lovely sounds, but completely different. No wonder people think ASMR videos are weird. If someone had no idea what ASMR was and has just tuned in and I'm like listening to the crinkle of bubble wrap, I don't blame them for thinking, what am I watching? But for the rest of us in the group, we can truly appreciate the different qualities of the crinkle. What's this? A bag? Some saccharis Saccharis crisps, chips, oregano. Oregano. Fancy that. They taste nicer than the smell. Smell is literally just oregano. There's nothing else to it. It smells like if you opened a jar of oregano. But the taste, there's much more depth to the taste. Saltiness. A little bit of onion in there maybe. Lemon powder, lemon juice. On one hand, they're like nothing I've tasted before. But on the other hand, they're very familiar. Like obviously I've had oregano before, but I've never had oregano crisps. But they still have that crisp quality to them. Where you know that you're eating crisps. If that makes any sense. They're lovely. You could eat them with like hummus and stuff. Stuff warm. One more. A note. Greek crisps with oregano. I love these. Advice sent me too. They're nice. They're very... like almost, I don't know. It's unusual to have oregano on a crisp because normally I'm very Italian. That's it. Whenever I cook Italian food, I usually put oregano in, and it reminds me of eating a spag bol, not a spag bol, like a carbonara. I had a carbonara last night, but not a proper Italian one. But it reminds me of eating a creamy pasta, Italian pasta, because of the oregano. They're nice. these seem to be of a similar... similar nature. One's not. Okay. So here we have what seems to be, oh, got a little angel sticker on. Like wafer biscuits or wafer filled with cocoa cream. Then we've got something I'm not going to try and pronounce. Kukuruku. And that again looks like a wafer with chocolate, but doesn't say anything in English on it. Then we have milk chocolate covered wafer. Looks like dark chocolate, but it doesn't say anything in English. Or does it? Nope, all in Greek. This wrapper reminds me of perfume 2711. I think it's 2711. I've mentioned this before in a video, with the like turquoisey blue and gold black. There's a perfume called 2711 and it reminds me of that so much. I think I'm just gonna try one of these because they're all a very similar kind of thing. I'm going to try this one, the something something by Ion. I can't even try and do this language. Usually if it's a German box I could have a go, but I can't even attempt it with this because I don't know their alphabet. It's a little bit like if it was Russian, I couldn't even try Russian. These should make a good sound. This is identical to a blue riband. Identical. I could be eating a blue riband. Do that with these boxes. Get something I like and fill up on it earlier on, and then like halfway down the box I can't manage anymore. There was another one I pulled out. Kiss. Reminds me of, what movie was it? Boomerang. If you've seen the movie Boomerang with Eddie Murphy, you'll know what I'm giggling at. The product called Kiss and the advert about Grace, was it Grace Jones? Grace Jones wasn't in the advert, but it was her product. Was she called Stranger? Or was a product called Stranger? Something like that. But I remember, I think we have a Petter. Possibly. I think a little fur baby friend came over. I love seeing those because it's like a little bit of their pet made it over as well. Yeah, it reminds me of the kiss, 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 kiss me once, kiss me twice. If you are under the age of 15, don't YouTube that. Okay. Strawberry. Chewy. Oh my goodness, that is delicious. Chocolate. Really nice and creamy. And strawberry. The smell of the strawberry. It's very, very overpowering almost, the smell. But the taste isn't. It's a little bit like with the crisps. The smell was mild, the taste was really nice, the opposite with that. It's really overpowering, the smell, but the taste, not at all. I want to eat all of it. Not yet. That is very nice. All the information I can give you from it is that it's called Kiss. Kiss Strawberry. Oh my goodness, that's good. I like that. Right, I'm going to see what's in this bag. Some hearts and angels on the front. See some snowflakes. Oh, I don't think you can see it, but I can see through it. Looks like a decoration. Those of you who know me know I love Christmas tree ornaments. I love like having a tree full of stories, essentially. Individual decorations that people have bought me, my mum's got me, I've got on holiday, they've been passed down, I've had, you know, stuff from family members who aren't with us anymore on my tree. I love having loads of different things on my tree. And this is gorgeous. I don't have any angel wings. Huge as well. My angel will be very jealous because she doesn't have wings as big as this. I'm sad that I'm going to have to wait until December. December rolls around and I get all my decorations, I'll have forgotten that these are there. I forget about all my decorations, I'll keep pulling things out and I'm like, oh, I forgot I had this. If they're about 5 year old plus, I remembered about them, but there are things every single year that I open and I totally forgot that I bought. Like, so this year I bought something from Amsterdam, like a blue and white porcelain one. So I'd put that away in May, then December came around and I was like, oh, I forgot I bought this. So come December, I'm gonna get this out and be like, oh my goodness, that's what Vicky got me. And it's gonna have a lovely spot on my tree. Throw a party in Greece and not have these. Pick butternuts. So I think these are like salty sticks. Oh, they've got sesame seeds on. Let me just get my Viper. They smell nice. Basically just like a breadstick, a very small breadstick, salt on, but sesame seeds. And the stick just tastes like a salty toasted sesame breadstick. So good. Can't eat anymore. But I want to. Maybe if I have a little one. Just a little one. I know my Greek viewers. Very, very familiar with these. Does every single party you go to have these there? They'd just be like, you know, just salty sticks, but they're really nice. It's the sesame on it. I'm a big fan of sesame seeds. When I cook Chinese food, I always use toasted sesame oil because I love it. and they just taste like so toasted sesame oil. This box might be two videos or two sittings. Mini croissant with mille flavour cream. I don't know what that is. I haven't pronounced it correctly and all that much. So she's put a sticker on that says, I actually live and work in London at the moment, and the most annoying thing about it is that these don't exist here. They are so tasty. Mini croissant with vanilla flavoured cream. Ooh, okay. What if you have to heat them up? I am a big croissant fan. Every morning I have a butter, large butter croissant. And at the minute I tend to switch what I'm having on it. At the moment I have a little blob of butter. Obviously I have it heated up in the oven, so it's nice and crispy and flaky. I have a little blob of butter, and at the moment I'm having honey. So I bought a pot of borage, or a jar of borage honey. I love borage honey. I'm a big honey fan, but what I've noticed is the darker the honey, the less I like it. Manuka honey, not a fan. And my mum bought me some honeys back from, one was from Toulouse, it was a lime tree, honey from a lime tree, and then honey from somewhere else, I can't remember where, somewhere in Spain I think, and that was a quite dark one, and I just wasn't keen on the flavour. The lighter the honey, the more I like it. And my auntie and uncle got me some borage honey for Christmas, which is difficult to come by now up here because there's no big borage fields. Anyway, I got given that on Christmas Eve. It got used up the beginning of last week. There's none left. Because I'm like a nice big teaspoon of honey every day. And it's gone. Gutted. Big honey fan. Well, a light honey fan. My boyfriend, he's not allowed to touch the borage honey, because to him, honey's honey. It's a little bit like how, for me, Coke and Pepsi are basically the same thing. I wouldn't know which one I was drinking, I couldn't tell them apart. Honey's like that for him, he's just like, it all tastes the same, whereas I'm very, no, this is a different flavour to this. I had a rapeseed one from a Christmas market the year before last, and that was really nice, really creamy. Creamy, mild honeys. Oh. So that's me chatting enough rubbish about something that has nothing to do with what I'm about to do. Really excited to eat this. I don't know why. I've gone into excited child mode. My goodness, it smells like brioche. It smells exactly like brioche, and they're so, oh my goodness, they're so soft and flaky. These are dangerous. I could soon eat so many of these. The pastry is just so light, so fluffy. crumbly all over my tablecloth.
Oh my goodness. I 100% get why you're sad they're not over here.
Serrano milk chocolate with cocoa cream filling. I'm going to save this for tonight while I'm editing and I get my 10 o'clock cup of tea. I don't really get it on the dot, but I always have a cup of tea in the evening after dinner. And I'm sat editing and I just want something chocolatey to eat. I'm going to save that. And the text, the actual font, makes it look so appealing. It just makes it look like it's super creamy and I don't know why, but I really like that font. Okay, we have my great-grandma, Vasiliki, that's what we're going with, used to buy these for me. It is commonly fed to babies as their first treat. Miranda biscuits. I'm going to put these to one side in case there's another set of biscuits like this that I can do for Biscuits of Britain and Beyond, because we've not had a Greek entry. But if not, then I'll try them. Or I could do it with a different country. It could be Greece versus somewhere else. Just changing the rules up as I go here. So we definitely won't be trying all of these. That was like one layer of three. Some items out that I won't try on the video, because I'd probably try with like dinners or lunches and things. So we have crackers here. Now these look like cracker with oregano and feta cheese flavour. And this one is crackers with tomato and basil. I am a cracker fan. I like to have pâté. When I have pâté, I always get some fancy crackers to go with them. On next Thursday, I work on an evening. So next Thursday, for dinner, is what I call picky tea night. For picky tea night, we'll probably have buffalo mozzarella, one of the flakes of croissant got in my throat. We'll have buffalo mozzarella wrapped in parma ham and grilled. Delightful. Then that will be with some baby leaf salad, tomatoes, balsamic vinegar. Then we'll have like flaked salmon, olives, hummus, chips, pate, crackers, and maybe some dough balls. So I just put it out in a big platter and we can just pick from what we want. So I'm going to save those for picky tea night on Thursday. Cinnamon candy. It'll be interesting. Fresh breath, hot taste. Yeah, might save those till the end. They sound like some sort of trick candy. Not that they're sold as a trick candy, but they're probably one of those candies like Fisherman's Friend, where they're ridiculously hot.
nougat with almond and cranberry. It's a very crinkly packet. I've just heard a knock. I hope that's not someone knocking on my door. I have a doorbell though as well. People sometimes just knock and forget the doorbell. It says it's got the Greek word, I'm assuming, for almond and cranberry, but it looks like tomato. Mantotato. So it looks like a nugget with tomato. Got some 2711 again. Number one chocolate in Greece for over 155 years. So it's obviously very popular. I'm going to have a taste. Cutting that snap out. That was very loud. So I think it's dark chocolate, which I'm not a fan of. It's too bitter for me, but I'll have a taste anyway. It's not bitter. For dark chocolate, it's actually very smooth. To leave this video last time because I think I had to go to work or I had to go somewhere, and as you can tell, it's a different day. I've just not had time to get around to filming this. This box has been sat full of treats in my office for about 5 days now. I'm dying to see what's inside. I'm not going to open everything in the box. There are so many treats, like ridiculous amounts of treats. And what I don't want to do is open everything and have a little taste of everything, because then I'm gonna have loads of packets of open food in the house, and if I can't eat them in time, then they'll get wasted. So what I'm gonna do is go through them all and then just open a few. So the first one is herbal tea, mountain tea, traditional Cretan thousands, but looks like a yogurt or an ice cream. Vanilla sweet. Dip a spoonful of vanilla sweet in a glass of cold water and enjoy. We call this a submarine. Dip a spoonful into a glass of cold water. I'm just gonna go and get a spoon. Okay. So I've got my spoon. I'm gonna put it in my water and see what it tastes like. Is it meant to dissolve? Dip a spoonful. Dip. Are you meant to stir it and dissolve it, or just dip it? Like, am I just dipping it? Am I meant to stir it? I don't think this was gonna dissolve at all. This is very unusual. Okay, so we've dipped the spoon. I'm just gonna leave the spoon in. I don't know what to expect. So there's literally no dissolving this. I've given it a really good stir. You can even see the ends around it. Let's have a taste. It's kind of like if you put a few vanilla drops in a glass of water. Use it on something else, like cakes or something. It's not unpleasant by any means. It's a pleasant drink. It's vanilla water. If you imagine, I don't know if everyone gets cream soda. If you imagine cream soda that's flat, but isn't just sugary. Like that. Greek honey. It's a light honey with a not a deep rich flavour, but there's like it's not light. It's like got this medium like I can't say what it is. You know when you get like wildflower honey, you can almost taste the wildflowers. Premium Greek honey varieties include wildflower, herb, forest and thyme honey. Miniature pillowcase. Thank you. services. Oh, but it'll be on that website, won't it? I'll need, like, something to filter it out. As you can see, a few are being crushed. But I'm not opposed to a crushed biscuit. Very soft, not what I expected. Very soft. Strong. drunk test, 0. 0. Put texture. Really nice. Ooh. Those things you sent. Those, you know, those sticks with the sesame seeds on. On the camera. Those things with the sesame seeds on, the little sticks that you get at Greek parties. Oh. Oh. They went in the same day. I had them on this table. My boyfriend came home from work. I said, try one of these. He loved them just as much as me. He was like, oh my god, give me some more. They were so good. So they've all been eaten. Caprice. Ooh. What do these look like? Biscuits of Britain fans. These look very, very similar to something I've just eaten on Biscuits of Britain. Papadopoulos. I'll stick an extra Lopoulos in there. Ones for downstairs because we've run out of biscuits. So tonight when I get home from work, I'm gonna enjoy those. Multi-seeded wheat breads, crumb sticks, I think is the correct translation. I'm opening these. Oh, I do love the sesame seed. Very crunchy. Nice. They would be nice dipped in hummus. Be here forever. Oh, she's marked up which ones are for Biscuits of Britain. Okay, so we've got the biscuits, my great grandma. biscuits with a lemon cream filling. I have to choose which ones of these to do for biscuits of Britain. No, these ones. For biscuits of Britain and beyond, I've been instructed. So these have cranberries in them. Cranberries and oats, it looks like. The fact she's entering these into Biscuits of Britain tells me she's very confident in their taste. Well, only time will tell. Made in 1922, these biscuits are the most famous in Greece. I think we have the second contender. I don't mind putting, you know, a French biscuit and an Italian biscuit side by side, but I always think it's fun to have biscuits from the same country together and then see where they go on the scoreboard. I hope these particular biscuits weren't made in 1922, because they'd be well past their sell-by date and their use-by date. November 2018. Yeah, those are definitely gone with the cranberry ones. Very pleasant sound. And what I think of the last biscuits. Oh no. The biscuits are Britain and beyond. Oh my goodness. Well. Okay, so these can go up against the cranberry ones. Tournament though, how would they fare? Would there be uproar in Greece if these didn't get on the Biscuits of Britain and Beyond scoreboard? I need to think carefully about that. I wouldn't want to cause a ruckus in Greece because their biscuits didn't make it onto the scoreboard. But we have our two biscuits, these. These remind me biscuits I used to get when I was younger, when we first started shopping at Aldi, and they looked exactly the same. They were a biscuit with the chocolate over the top, and I used to nibble the chocolate off the ends and then eat the biscuit. They look exactly the same as that, and they were delicious biscuits. Green tea with ginger, licorice, and Greek saffron. Oh, ginger and licorice. They're my two favourite things. I feel like it's one of those things, licorice, that not many people like. I love licorice. I love Turkish Delight. Fries Turkish Delight. All over that. Not many people like it. Who wouldn't love a sweet that
we have some mini big rolls. So we have mini big rolls classic, which look like a hard bagel. These ones are pizza flavour. I'm going to try them. For some reason I thought they'd be bigger. I don't know why. I think I've got it in my head that they look like bagels, so they're going to be like mini bagels. They're really nice. Oh my goodness. One more. Oh my goodness, I like them. They taste like a margarita pizza. Very tomatoey. It's a really nice crunch. Oh my goodness, they're so good. They're so good. I really want another one, but I'm not going to. Because straight after here, after filming this, I have to eat dinner and go to work. And if I eat too much of this, I won't eat dinner. And then I'll have only eaten like a biscuit. Just so I can have them with my picky dinner. Oh, they're so nice. I can't believe how much it tastes like pizza. I see why you sent them. They're real good. Just the colour of them. They look like they've been sprinkled on something. I like pistachio nuts. Pistachio nuts are one of those things where you sit and just pick, and before you know it, you've eaten like 50 of them. And you've always got to have that half a shell to go in and open the tough ones. I've just punched myself in the face there. And oh,
These came about in the 50s. These look like Turkish delight. I'm still. What a lovely wrapper. These are Turkish delight. They look like them and they're soft like them. They are. Oh my god, they're Turkish delight. My SD card just ran out there. So this is a long video. I think we are definitely looking. My neighbour's singing. She always sings. Yeah, so I know this video is probably going to be over an hour long. So as I was saying before my SD card cut me off is, my mum is a big fan of Turkish delight. So I think it might have been one of those things where you're brought up with it. You learn to like it a bit like tea. If someone who's never had tea tasted, they'd be like, it's just milky, mild flavoured hot water. But because I've been brought up with it, I can sit down and enjoy a cuppa and be like, oh, this is amazing. It makes me feel better. So I think that might be why I like Turkish delight so much. I've still got a load of stuff in the box to do. So I'm just going to go through them now. We have mastic drops. Sugar-free mastic drops. From an English person's point of view. I don't know if you can hear us singing. Mastic is isn't it the stuff that, like, it's like a sealant? You have a mastic gun. I think it's like that. So mastic drops sound really unhealthy to eat, but obviously they're not. Maybe them. Oh, hold on, mastic oil. Mastic drop candies, 100% natural essence of Chios mastic, which is produced from the teardrop of a lentisk mastic tree. Mastic, well known for its therapeutic attributes since ancient times, seemed to contribute substantially to the healing of gastric ulcer, helps digestion and relieves stomach aches. Oh, well, these are interesting. I thought they were just mints. I'm going to do a little bit more research on these. These sound like almost like a bit of a health food thing. You know, when you have certain things, if you're not well and you have it, it's kind of half sweet, half, you know, thing that'll settle your tummy. It's gone from, oh my god, mastic drops to, oh, they sound really good. I've got some pollen. Just kidding. Greek chamomile. A natural product from Greece. Chamomile is a widespread aromatic herb of Greek nature. Boil chamomile as a beverage. Besides its characteristic aroma and flavour, chamomile is also known for its medicinal properties, which contribute to the physical and mental well-being, as well as the euphoria of the human body.
this for my brother when he comes up and we can try it. I don't want to open it. He's coming up in a few months. He loves this sort of stuff, so I'm going to keep it nice and fresh in the packet. And we can try it. He's a tea. Actually, he's more of a coffee drinker. But he does like his herbal teas. They're very flowery teas. That it's crisp rice wrapped in white chocolate with maybe a nougat or praline centre. That's my guess. Yeah. That is my guess. Is this more mastic? Oh no, not. It's Biopharma Dimfil. Little dates, as couples in the 60s used to eat one before they kissed. So they are hard-boiled sweets with flavours. See if I can see the flavour. Refreshing breath since 1956. Their flavour on the front. Okay, no flavour. Hold on, glucose, natural flavour. It just says natural flavouring. It doesn't actually say what flavour. So we have a red flavour, which I am going to guess is possibly cinnamon. Then we have green and yellow, mint and lemon. Any advances on mint and lemon?
where you pull it, it's got like the little foil sound. But this is a different top. Generosity has blown me away. You've just sent me so.